Hello friends, welcome to my modern knowledge video class. I am Rajesh Jha. I am an agriculture student, that's why I have a specific knowledge about agriculture. In this channel, you can see about all updated knowledge and information of all subjects of agriculture, traditional cultures, technical educations and IQ test, etc. In this video, we will discuss about chapter 4 of agribusiness. This is an agriculture subject and before starting our class, I am going to say something about agriculture because agriculture is the life of our. Without agriculture, life is not possible on the earth. Let's start our class. Our first topic is principle involved in farm management decision. There are seven principles involved in farm management decision. As first, principle of diminishing return. Second, cost principle or principle of cost. Third, principle of substitution. And fourth, principle of combining enterprises. Fifth, principle of equal marginal return. Sixth, principle of competitive advantage. And the last seventh is principle of time comparison. These are the seven principles involved in farm management decision. First, we discuss about principle of diminishing return. Hello friends, welcome to my modern knowledge video class. I am Rajesh Jha. I am an agriculture student, that's why I have a specific knowledge about agriculture. In this channel, you can see about all updated knowledge and information of all subjects of agriculture, traditional cultures, technical educations and IQ test, etc. In this video, we will discuss about chapter 4 of agribusiness. This is an agriculture subject and before starting our class, I am going to say something about agriculture because agriculture is the life of our. Without agriculture, life is not possible on the earth. Let's start our class. Our first topic is principle involved in farm management decision. There are seven principles involved in farm management decision. As first, principle of diminishing return. Second, cost principle or principle of cost. Third, principle of substitution. And fourth, principle of combining enterprises. Fifth, principle of equal marginal return. Sixth, principle of competitive advantage. And the last seventh is principle of time comparison. These are the seven principles involved in farm management decision. First, we discuss about principle of diminishing return. Our first topic is principle of diminishing return, and it's also called law of variable proportion, or it's also called three stages of production process. First topic is principle of diminishing return. Law of variable proportion or three stages of production function. These are its names, and the principle of diminishing return state that, listen carefully, principle of diminishing return state that if increasing amount of one input are added to the production process while all other inputs are held constant, the amount of output added per unit of variable input will eventually decline or decrease after a certain point. I repeat the principle of diminishing return states. Listen very carefully. The law of diminishing return states that if increasing amount of one input are added to the production process, while all other inputs are held constant, the amount of output added per unit of variable input will eventually decline or decrease after a certain point. And it contains three steps. Step 1, it is called stage of increasing return. Step 2, stage of diminishing return. Step 3, stage of negative return. It also called first stage, second stage or third stage. This is the graphic representation of principle of diminishing return, and this is stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. Stage 1 is called irrational, stage 2 is called rational, and stage 3 is also irrational. And this point is called point of inflection. It points is and average product is equal to marginal product. This is total product, this is average product, and this is marginal product. Stage 3 before the this line, it goes to marginal product goes to negative, and this is the graphical representation of principle of diminishing return. And the next topic is stage 1. Stage 1, see carefully here. In this stage, more use of variable input. There is a more use of variable input. Increase its production, increase its physical production efficiency. Physical production efficiency. Indicated by continuous increase in AP, AP and average product. In combination with fixed input, so it is irrational to stop. So it is irrational to stop increasing the use of variable input as long as fixed input are not fully utilized. There is a scarcity of variable input in relation to fixed factor of production. Hence, this stage is called irrational. Irrational. Here is a question because why stage 1 is called irrational, and this question is very important. So learn this definition now. And the next topic is stage 2. And in stage 2, MP, yani marginal product, is very important for deciding how much to produce, because it represents the rate of return. It represents the rate of return. This stage is called rational because marginal product and average product are positive and marginal product declines but not negative. In this stage, resources are utilized efficiently, but total product is increasing and finally gets maximum. In this topic, the important question is why stage 2 is called rational, and we have to write this all, and this is very important for this question. Learn it. And our last topic is stage 3, and its description are, this stage is called irrational because excessive quantities of variable input is being used. Excessive quantities of variable input is being used relative to available fixed factors, that total product start to decline and it decline continuously, and MP becomes negative. If the farmer operate in this stage, they will incur double loss, that is reduced production and unnecessary additional cost of inputs. This is the description of stage 3, and the most important question is why stage 3 is called irrational, and we have to write this all. And that's our topics are finished. If you want to more than more information on this subject, please like and subscribe this video, and for motivating me to upload more than more videos. If the video is necessary for other friends, and then share the video, and thank you for watching, and never miss to like and subscribe. Thank you.